True.
Retired. Healthier than I was in my 20s. Proud grandpa of three. Ready for inspirational change of era. New visions. July 2015. I retired. Actually, last week. Question is, what did I retire from? Okay. Was it convention? Convention? I retired from convention, I don't know how long ago, okay. This is gonna be an extraordinarily unconventional retirement because it was an unconventional life so far. So, am I gonna go place 50p bets every afternoon in the bookies? No. Am I looking for a job at B&Q part-time? Nah. Am I gonna take up bowls? No. Okay. Right, so, have I retired from institutionalized thinking? You know, holiday forms, staff handbooks, health and safety, all those things. Well, believe me, that has gone, okay? Have I retired from overheads, staff, salary, rent, office, issues? Believe me, overheads are not overheads. They are in your heads, okay? I have retired from in my heads, the things that stop this free-flowing brain from free flowing. They're gone. Okay. Do you know what I've really done? I have retired disempowerment from my life. It's gone. So, question is, what did I actually do? Because to many, including my brothers, it was a mystery, right? I have been asked by my own brothers if it was just a facade, if I actually was in some form of intelligence agency, okay? Believe me, I did do something. And what's extraordinary is that even though most people don't actually know what I did, it's those people that we managed to actually stop from the possibility of freezing to death in their own homes in this country, in a developed world. They know, believe me, they know what I did for a living. However, it doesn't really matter, because how did I actually get here? Do you know what? I seriously did have an insane level of commitment to what I did. I saw an issue, an injustice, and for 7 years I worked my little butt off with huge levels of commitment to undo that injustice, and we did it, all right? So here's the thing, part two. I'm 49 this month, my 50th year starts. I am halfway through. This has been a rehearsal and the second half, oh my God. Talk about journey of discovery. Talk about every day with intention. Talk about an adventure every single day. As I said at the beginning, I'm surrounded by special people to do special, amazing things with. The extraordinary thing is that what's seriously important for the second half of my life is that I have discovered leverage and I have discovered how to harness leverage. Leverage of time, leverage in the most positive way of influence, okay? Leverage of money and how you actually make that work for you. Okay, seriously. Mahatma Gandhi once wrote, "Be the change you want to see in the world." It's lived with me daily since I first read that, okay? Simple as this, I've made my change and I'm creating my history. Have you? And why did I really, really jump now? Because of this quote I saw recently. The quote simply goes, if you do not know where you want to be in 5 years' time, you are already there. Watch this space. Come, enjoy the journey. Join me on the journey with those extraordinary special people I'm working with, because things are just about to get excited.